Hi, I'm Justin, and I'm a Best Buy home expert. And today we're answering the question, what is a modem? Well, a modem is a device that converts the signal from your internet service provider, or ISP, into one that's recognizable by most internet devices, like a laptop or a gaming console. Now, most homes have a coax cable coming into their home, like this, and it's usually delivering the internet signal. Well, you can't just connect a coax cable directly to a device. Instead, you connect it to a modem, like this Netgear Nighthawk 32x8 DOCSIS 3.1 cable modem. It uses a telecommunication standard called DOCSIS, which stands for Data Over Cable Service Internet Specification, so it's there in the name. But to help define it a little more, the modem is taking the data from the line and converting it into a usable internet signal. From there, your modem sends the signal to your router in order to deliver internet to all of your devices. Pretty cool. So where do you get a modem? Well, the most common way is by renting it directly from your ISP. They usually include the cost as part of your monthly fee. Take a look at your latest statement and you might see it listed. However, you can purchase and use your own. You might choose to do this to save money so you're no longer paying the rental fee, or more likely, it's because the one your ISP provided isn't equipped with the latest and greatest technology. Speaking of, let's talk specifics. What's happening inside of that little box, and what are some of the latest enhancements that you should be aware of, especially if you're planning to purchase one? Like I said, the modem is translating the internet signal into one that your devices can use and recognize. They usually have a series of status lights, letting you know what's happening inside. For example, this light indicates that data is being sent and received, which means the modem is working properly. And the sending and receiving area is what can really set a modem apart, because, as you might have guessed, some are faster than others. For example, older modems are often referred to as DOCSIS 2.0 and only support speeds of 40 megabits per second download and 30 megabits per second upload. These speeds were considered good years ago. However, if you're using a number of connected devices in your house, then a DOCSIS 2.0 modem might not be providing enough output to deliver an ideal experience. Think of it as a basic two-lane highway where the traffic is confined and often slower. DOCSIS 3.0 or 3.1 is far more advanced, as it allows for channel bonding, which is when a cable modem combines multiple channels to increase the amount of traffic that it can comfortably support. The best way to understand this is to think of each channel as a lane of traffic. Instead of only a few lanes, these modems will offer many more, allowing the traffic to move much faster with reduced congestion. This Netgear Nighthawk 32x8 DOCSIS 3.1 cable modem has 32 downstream channels and 8 upstream. The higher the number of channels, the better it can support faster speeds. Now, it's important to note that the speed is largely dependent on your internet service. In other words, upgrading your modem won't necessarily have an impact on the overall speed if you're paying for a slower service. In summary, depending on the type of internet connection that you have, you might be able to save some money in the long run by purchasing your own cable modem. Just make sure to check with your ISP for compatibility. If you need help getting your system set up, we have some great videos to check out. Links are in the notes below. So there you have it. Hopefully you've learned more about modems. If you're ready to get started, visit a blue shirt in one of our stores, check out the options on bestbuy.com, or use the link below to set up time with a Best Buy home expert like me. We'll be happy to help. Thanks for watching.